a webinar for the future hospitality graduates. I welcome our guest speaker, Mr. Raja Sadhuka, Human Resource Manager at Taj Swarna Amritsar. He is a successful hotelier with an experience of 26 years. He started his career as a chef in the food production department and moved to academics as a lecturer with IHM Kolkata. He has worked with some of the finest luxury hotels in the Taj Group, like the Lake Palace Udaipur, Taj Ganges, Varanasi. Mr. Raja Sadhuka has been awarded the HR Person of the Year by Hotelier India in the year 2012. I welcome you, sir, on behalf of the team at IAS and on behalf of our students. Also present with us today is Dr. Anshuman Chatterjee, Director, IAS School of Management, Mr. Sandeepan Biswas, Assistant Principal, IAS School of Management. We have students from first year, second year, and third year of hotel management degree courses who are attending this webinar today. COVID-19 has almost brought everything to a halt, affecting almost every industry across the globe, with travel and tourism being one of the most badly affected. Nonetheless, things are getting under control to some extent, new measures are being implemented, and people across the globe have decided to live with COVID-19. I would now request Dr. Anshuman Chatterjee to kindly speak a few words.
Thank you, Sukhbir. Good afternoon, students and my colleagues. It is very difficult to explain how fortunate we all are today that Mr. Sadhuka has joined us for a session. And you shall be glad to know that Mr. Sadhuka and I used to share the same classroom, as well as we have worked as colleagues. So as a student, I had seen him not only very good in academics, but in taking a regular part in co-curricular activities, as well as disciplinarian right from his student life. I have also seen him functioning as a teacher and a trainer. He is a teacher par excellence. And I have always, in different forums, I have talked about him being an ideal teacher. So he has seen both sides of it in the industry, as well as as a teacher, as a trainer. And now, after going back to the industry, he is looking after all the people in our industry, that is, as the HR manager. And it was very fitting that he was awarded the best HR manager in the country by Hotelier India. So I'm sure that our students are going to benefit from today's association with Mr. Sadhuka. And I request the students, you can ask him anything pertaining to the topic or anything even outside it when the Q&A session starts. So the platform to Mr. Sadhuka.
Thank you, sir. I am feeling honored. I thank the IAS School of Management, Mr. Bogal, and Mr. Chatterjee for such a nice introduction. I'm feeling really humble. And one of my identity, of course, remains as I am a student of Mr. Anshuman Chatterjee, Dr. Anshuman Chatterjee. And it's been a long, long association from 1991. So I was looking forward to this interaction, and I always make myself available whenever I have an opportunity to speak to the bright minds who are the future of this industry. Now, we look to the current scenario which we are facing. Now, see, COVID has taken a toll on every industry, but the worst sufferer possibly has been our industry, the hospitality, the tourism industry, the aviation industry, which we look forward for a good career. Now, the hospitality industry in terms of, you know, it is the largest employer of manpower globally, and it is always it's also the largest contributor to GDP globally. But somehow, because of this recent happenings, the entire industry has taken a toll and has come to a standstill. But, you know, we in Tata and Taj, we have taken certain different routes of how to revive this industry. Like currently, the hotel that I am in, Taj Swarna in Amritsar, the hotel is functional and we have guests staying with us. So what has been happening in these few days is how we are adopting to the changes in the new environment. Let me show you something before I start off. See this hand sanitizer, this mask, these gloves, and other PPEs related to our workplace has become part of our life, which we can't segregate now, which we can't separate now, at least for very recent times to come. It can be 6 months, it can be 1 year, till situations are normal. But once that we are faced with such pandemic, it has come to us as a challenge, which we have accepted and we have excelled. We have come with a solution. Till the point the vaccine is being taken out, we have a solution with ourselves. The first and foremost thing that we need to remember is that we are responsible not only for ourselves, but also for others around us. It can be my family, it can be my relatives, it can be friends, it can be colleagues, it can be co-pedestrians, it can be fellow citizens. So we are actually responsible for everybody. I'll start off as how we are functioning in this hotel. Now see, every guest who is given a booking, his ID used to be collected previously at the hotel itself, which was handed over at the reception. Now things are absolutely online. So a guest is only taken when he is booked with us and who shares his ID and all his travel details. Secondly, when he is checking in, we are sanitizing his luggage immediately as he comes in. When he is queuing up, we are ensuring that our associates are maintaining a social distance but assisting him. In a hotel-like environment, we have to be assisting guests at all point of time. So we are assisting him or her, but now maintaining a little distance, right? Then the food that we are serving him is now being packed separately, single portions, and delivered to his room. We are not operating with any restaurants. So in the room, we are placing hand sanitizers, masks, swipes, whatever is required to keep himself safe. So the guest, whoever checks in, always feels comfortable and safe. That is the first priority of this. Now, whoever associates, those associates who are with us, we are ensuring that they are safe with us. We are checking temperatures on daily basis of the associates and of the guests. If there is a slight problem, if you're noticing, thank God, not as on date, we have not noticed any problem. So we have kept our emergency team ready, our hospitals ready, so that we can immediately get in with them. But as of now, we are maintaining a lot of social distancing, a lot of precautionary measures, a lot of PPEs in place so that everybody is safe, not only the guests, but also the associates who are working in the industry. Now let us come to the city where I am in Amritsar. In Amritsar, Taj is the only brand which is operational. If I talk about the other brands, they have actually closed down. There are a lot of repatriation which is happening from other countries. A lot of Indians who are coming back and a lot of hotels wants to get them back. Taj is one of them who has tied up with the government of India, government of Punjab, and is okay to take in quarantine guests also. Now, why we need to understand this is that if we get afraid or if we take the fear of COVID, then we'll not be able to survive in this industry. The industry has given us a challenge, and the challenge is now we have to be more conscious about safety, hygiene, and security. Whenever you look forward to a Tata brand or a Taj brand, the guest has always seen this as a very safe place, very comfortable place. When I talk about the Taj and Tata, you must be listening in various chats, you must be reading in various newspapers and in various TV shows. You must be hearing that Taj Group has started delivering a lot of packed foods to the doctors, to the migrant workers, to others who need them. Hotels in Mumbai, Delhi, we have opened up for doctors, nurses, healthcare workers, tied up with the government. So we are into a lot of philanthropic, and that is how the Tata and Taj Group has always functioned. We have a very strong corporate social responsibility team. We are dedicated to corporate social responsibility, and we take these philanthropic activities wholeheartedly. So now let us see, in a new situation, what will be or how will the hospitality industry function? See, particularly when we talk about hotels, in hotels we have rooms division and we have foods division. In room division, we not only have rooms, we have other allied services also, like concierge and travel desk, like spa, gym, beauty parlor, salon, swimming pools. In F&B, we have banqueting, we have restaurants, we have bars, we have in-room dining. Now let's see one by one. Let's talk about one by one. Now there are certain norms which the government of India is informing us about. For example, one of the norms which is coming is not more than one occupant per room. If there is a family, exceptions can be made. Naturally, if a husband and wife is coming together, we cannot tell them, please stay separate. So, but the norm is you have to have single occupancy first. Secondly, the moment the guest checks out, you have to sanitize the entire room and keep it locked for 72 hours before you give it to the other person. There are some specific sanitization programs. There are some specific sanitizers, disinfectants, which we are supposed to use, which we are using. The staff, the associate who cleans the room has to be a complete hazard prevention suit. You must have seen the one which doctors are wearing. So our housekeeping staff or anybody entering our guest room has to be in that hazmat suit, where he has a face shield, he has eye goggles, entire body is covered in the suit with a shoe cover, gloves on. So the maximum masks, maximum protection which someone can get. So then once he is in the room, how do we reach out with the services? We are not functioning any of our restaurants right now. So we are delivering all our foods to the room in the room service trolley. And once we are at his door, we ring the bell and we leave the trolley informing the guest that his food is here. But when we started with the restaurant operations, then we have to also keep in mind the restaurants, the tables, the chairs has to be placed, maintaining the social distancing, right? Which will be about 2 meters apart from each other and not more than 2 covers on a table. That too, if people are coming in family, as in family or in friends. So there are a lot of mathematics has been worked out. A lot of space management is being done. A lot of cost factors is put in place. See, in hotel industry, we have seen a lot of ups and downs. We have seen a lot of depression coming in. We have seen a lot of pandemic like this in the past also. I recall one such pandemic was swine flu when I was with Taj Lake Palace. And suddenly there was a lot of dip in the business and people were very scared. Then luckily, there were vaccinations which were out and we could actually vaccinate everybody in the hotel. So I'm sure this pandemic also will see its end. There will be a lot of vaccination program which is going on. People are trying to make a vaccination out of it. And I'm sure it is going to come in short time. But till then, we have to live in the reality that is it exists. But if we are cautious, if we maintain certain hygiene standards, if we maintain certain safety standards related to, you know, food, room, you know, working space, whatever we do, it will not affect us and the guests. So we have to be responsible for ourselves also. We have to be responsible for others also.
So what are the measures that we're following there at the hotel for the staff, like at the security entrance or maybe the use of lockers, right? What measures are new in there? Because I'm sure there are students here, you've come from training, they've done their training the second and third year. They have an idea of what the staff area looks like, but I'm sure with the present situation, there's a huge change in there also. So if you could just give us a brief insight of how the staff, are you dealing with the staff as well?
Right, Mr. Vogel. Now, what is happening is, as I told you, that health and safety is of paramount importance. It is of paramount importance to all of us. Now, what we have done is that we have segregated the entire team that is with us into two. One is people who are required to be present in the hotel premises and people who can work from home. As I was talking about space management, in the hotel lockers, if you see in most of the hotels, the locker space is not much and the lockers are in sharing. Right? Luckily for us, we have segregated the entire associates into two. One is people who should be working here on premises and people who can manage their jobs and work from home. For example, say for example, the revenue manager. The revenue manager needs a good system to work from. He may not be present here. Similarly, our reservation executive can also work from home. Most of the sales team can also work from home. Whereas on the shop floor, we would require our chefs, our F&B personnel, our housekeepers, our front office associates to be present. So now what we are doing is whenever they are coming as an entry, when they are taking an entry through Prime Office, first and foremost is we have maintained social distancing there by creating some barricades where people should not come and push each other. If they have to come, they have to come through disciplined way, right? They have to step in. If you recall what the way an airport entry happens, there is a DFMD and there is a person who is being checked on the other side of the DFMD and the passengers has to queue up. Right? I hope I've been able to give you a picture.
Yes, you are so, indeed, sir.
So, one of the associate waits at a marked place. When the other associate crosses the DFMD, we are not doing any frisking right now so that we are, you know, we have to make it more contactless services, contactless things. So, we are not doing any frisking, physical frisking right now. So, they pass through DFMD. And they declare if they are carrying anything, if they're carrying, we have certain rules. And the Taj values are trust, awareness, and joy. So we trust our associates. So if they tell us that we have 5,000 rupees in our wallet, so we believe them. And we write that in a document, we put in a documentation, we write it. That Raja Sadhugan is carrying 5,000 rupees today. So there is no physical frisking. The person comes through DFMD, declares his belongings, he is offered a hand sanitization and the mask he has come from his home is thrown in a hazardous dustbin and is given a fresh mask. Now then he steps in, he goes to the uniform room, collects his uniform, goes to the locker. The locker also, we have made sure that there should not be more than 15 people in the locker. So we have Yakmat, and there is one attendant at the locker who is standing, and it's very difficult and challenging, but he's counting the number of people coming and going out of the locker, right? So if a person comes in, and if there is an available space to go inside the locker, he's allowed. Otherwise, he's stopped at a particular point. So he goes, changes, reports to the duty. We have advised people to be at all times, to be wearing their PPEs. Also, at the time of his, when they're coming in, their temperature has been checked. We are also organizing a doctor who comes here and checks basic health checkups twice a week. We also want anybody staying in, close by to the hotel to use their own vehicles rather than using any public transport or taxis. That is how we have chosen our team. People who can walk down, or people who have their own vehicles, they can come along. And, the idea again is to be safe, not only for oneself, also to keep others safe. I should not be reason of spreading any disease to anybody. Forget about COVID. It cannot be, if you are sneezing also, if you have a normal flu, if you sneeze and do not maintain the sneezing etiquette, you can pass on the flu to others.
Thank you, sir. I hope that well explained the process of how the staff are being dealt with at the staff lockers. Another question that I had, do you also have provision for a quarantine room for staff members if anybody is found to be infected or has a high temperature or shows any symptoms? Are there provisions for that also?
Absolutely. Like
special? Okay.
Absolutely. You see, as I told you, Tata and Taj has a very different way of thinking and towards corporate social responsibility. So we also think of all our stakeholders. Stakeholders are those people who are directly linked with us, and it's a mutual benefit. So not only for guests, if any staff, right, is complaining, we can also keep him in quarantine for that. But as on date, as I told you, we have not got any cases of COVID for any of the Taj Swarma employees. Now, how do we know this, that our staff is keeping in good health? So what we have done is, every HOD gets connected, remains connected to all their associates. The HR manager and the general manager, we, every week, at a particular day, we randomly call people and make sure that within a week, we cover all the associates of ours and check whether they're okay or not. Monthly once, we have done our town hall in which we have connected all our associates over virtual communication and spoken to them to check whether they're okay or not. There is an emergency response team. Their number, their details have been shared with all the associates so that anybody in need, not only for any disease, if they have any requirement also, if they need some grocery, if they need something else, if they need to buy something, they can get in touch with us, and we can also deliver that to them. So that is how we have been mentioning here. In Punjab, the lockdown has been since March 23rd, and all our associates who are there in Amritsar, we have been in touch with them. And some of the associates, they requested if food can be given to them. We have ensured that food is delivered to them. Some, we have a sizable staff accommodation also. They run out of the gas, so they ensure that the gas is delivered to them. So we have been taking care of them in many, many ways.
Raja, I have a question. Suppose
yes.
You, in your rooms, it's about the rooms. Suppose you have a corridor and most hotels have, and you have rooms on both sides. Now, given this situation, suppose you get good bookings now or immediately after the lockdown, whatever. Are you going to rent out each room, or are you going to maintain a gap, like say every alternate room, something like that? If yes, then your lettable number of lettable rooms comes down. In that case, will the tariff be hiked? How are you planning to cope with such a situation?
So it's a very pertinent question in today's scenario, where every hospitality industry is trying to grab its business and make whatever profit it can. But sir, I can actually tell you on behalf of Taj Hotels that our intent is to make people safe. That is the first intent. There, as I told you, that there have been guidelines from the ministry and from FHRAI that whichever room we give has to be given on single occupancy. Number one, until and unless there is a family member and wants to stay along with the other person. Secondly, after the guest checks out, the room has to be sanitized and kept locked for 72 hours, that is 3 days. So there is a loss of revenue for 3 days. We will not be able to sell that room. But technically, we are actually not worried on that. It is the reputation of the company. It is the belief of people who looks towards Tata and Taj and says that, yes, if I'm in Taj, I'll be well taken care of. That is the first priority. Secondly, we are not going to hire any prices of the room. The room rates, if you study, the room rates are always from 1st April to September 30th, there is a different room rate. And from 1st October to 31st of March, which is the peak season, would be a different room rate. So the room rates would be as per the tariff which is available for these seasons. It will not be specially hiked for sure. But all the safety standards, whatever norms the government of India tells us or FHRI tells us, we will 100% adhere to that as a hotel group, and we'll ensure the safety of all our stakeholders, our guests, our associates, vendors, partners, community, whoever is in touch with us.
That is a fantastic decision, and you can pass on our salutes to your management.
Thank you so much, sir.
We have a question from Chef Shomajit Agasti. He's a faculty of food production with IAA School of Management.
Yes.
He wants to know what additional measures have been implemented regarding the receiving of raw materials and in the food production department.
Yes, very pertinent. I would like to thank Chef Agasti to bring out this question. Now, what we are doing is, see, we have sanitizing all the vegetables which is coming in the hotel. Now, whatever non-perishable items which are there, we have made a bay at our time office, and the vendor is delivering, and the non-perishables are kept for 24 hours. And the perishables and the like vegetables, we are washing in the chlorine tank and taking it to the kitchen area and keeping it in a very safe place. Now, we are, of course, following, the storing process of veg, non-veg, and in non-veg, fish, chicken, mutton, in such a way that there is no cross-contamination, right? Similarly, what we are planning when we open our operations, we will try to avoid buffets. There will be no more buffets now, right? Because buffets, what happens is, you keep on touching the same ladle or the same lid one after the other. The same, the ladle is touched by multiple guests. So we will remove buffets. If we at all have buffet, there will be a dedicated buffet attendant who will do the portioning of the guests wearing required PPEs and keeping all sanitation and hygiene standards in mind. Now, what we have done as a practice in our staff restaurant, we call it the associate dining room. The associate dining room, the chef is serving the entire meal. We are not allowing anybody to touch. So we are practicing, and maybe in future, if the government permits us to open buffet, this is what we're going to bring in. Now, all standards of hygiene has been in place. All standards of sanitation has been put in place for all food items, which can be vegetables, which can be other products, and all standards are made. A chef, whenever he's working now on the range, chef cap was must, apron was must. Now he is wearing a mask also. And gloves also, wherever possible. Suppose, for example, a tandoor person, gloves will not be possible, right? Then he has to maintain his hand hygiene at all times. So that our chefs are ensuring, and as I have told you, all our basic, all our associates have been trained in this basic hygiene and the hygiene standards that they need to put in place. And these crisis hours, ensuring the health and safety of our guests and of our associates, it's all in place.
Thank you, sir. I hope that answers Mr. Agasthi's question. Rohan, yes, you've asked the question. Can you please let us know what your question is? You can type it there. So, looking at the present scenario, as you said, that we've not, the F&B service has not become operational as yet. So, if you could hopefully give us an idea, like, what are we looking at exactly? How long will it take for that department also to be operational? Are there any guidelines that you've received stating that maybe it's going to start later this time or anything like that?
You see, we, as of now, we are still awaiting for the guidelines. But as a group, we are putting the standard operating procedures in place, right? And that is for all departments. If it's F&B, be it front office, housekeeping, food production, heart of the house, we have all put in place the standard operating procedures and how we are going to function in the coming days. It cannot be an abrupt decision, okay, let's do something like this. So already the SOPs are in place. The SOPs have been, the head of the departments, the managers, they're taking all the associates through the SOPs, right? Now, for the what we have planned for F&B is a big chunk, and especially for a hotel like Taj Swarna, and especially being in Amritsar, which is a food's paradise. Now, our room to F&B ratio is almost 50-50. We heavily depend on banqueting. We heavily depend on our restaurants. Our restaurants are full for dinner in all days, be it Monday or Tuesday or a Saturday, Sunday, it's full for dinner. Our bar that we have, the Peg, earns the highest revenue in the entire city. So now what has happened is, now suddenly we have this social distancing which has come in. Now what we are doing is, there are two ways. One, we have created hampers for guests, right? Which, as of now, the guests are taking the delivery from the site, from the hotel itself. So we have created like a wellness hamper, right? Where you have the spa items put in place. Then we have created, the food hampers, where certain food which can be given is put in place. What we have also done is, we have been communicating with all our guests with a set of menu which they can order and they can pick up from here. Right? We also have the IRD in operation. We have also started calling guests and telling them, this is the menu that we can give you right now. Right? And this has certain longevity. You can take it and it will still be warm and you can have it. Enjoy that food. So we have had a huge response in this. Now going forward also, as I told you, direct directions from the Government of India is still awaited. But our SOPs, what we are going to do is, we will be starting with the restaurant services whenever the Government of India allows us, keeping in mind the social distancing. The tables would be with two covers. If there are family members, we look into it. If there is banqueting, we have to ensure that only those many number of people are there in the banquets will be allowed. All the hygiene standards will be maintained, right? If we have to use disposable, we'll be using disposable. If you are using a regular crockery, then we'll ensure that each of them is actually correctly sanitized and packed and given to the guest.
Raja, I have two specific questions, one in F&B and one in engineering, let's say. F&B, about the menu, there's a lot of discussion in different forums that once restaurant dining starts, the structure of the menu, the physical menu, will change, for at least for the times to come, maybe for a year, two years or whatever. That is one part. And there is a lot of skepticism about the use of air conditioning. You see, people are talking about air conditioning inside an aircraft or inside a train. Similarly, inside hotel rooms or restaurants, that you should not breathe the same AC, because it's central AC. So I don't know if something is being thought about this particular air conditioning aspect, as well as the menu card presentation.
Right, sir. Actually, we have thought on both of them. See, the menu card, sir, what is going to happen going forward is now we'll no longer have buffet. For at least for some time, we'll no longer have buffet. Until unless we get the guidelines, and with the buffet attendant, we can start off. So buffet actually is a huge spread. And most of the diners, they prefer buffet because at a very competitive price, you have a lot of choices. Now, as of now, what we are going to have is we're going to have a menu which will be absolutely tailor-made and to an extent which also satisfies the guests and also is good enough for the number of team members that you're going to have in the kitchen now. They'll be able to manage. So for example, now if we had about 15 team members, now we have to function with about 7 to 10 team members in that kitchen. So the menu has to be tailored in such a way, not only it is easy to make and deliver, also is to the liking and choice of the guests. So this has been worked out. So our chef and the team, they're working on this new menu concept. And also, the physical layout and designing of the menu will change. You used to have a huge menu card with a lot of pages and turning those pages. Now this, we're going to offer this menu to the guests. Now in today's world, what is going to happen is every menu that we offer has to be laminated and has to be sanitized before it passes on to the other guests. So keeping in mind all of these, the menu designing, the menu planning is still under process, it is going on. In the interim, as I just informed, that we have worked out on the menu and we have shared with our guests online, right, on their WhatsApp, on their mobile, through internet, about our packages, about our hampers, and we are encouraging them to order from here. Similarly, the resident guests, those are here. What we are doing is we are taking their phone numbers and we are sending them the menu through WhatsApp. So when they are calling to the room service, they can either check with the order taker what's in the menu, or they can refer to the menu which is already there with them on the WhatsApp. So that is how we have made it. Similarly, for AC also, what we have done is we have did a study and it has been said if the AC is set to 24 degrees centigrade, the central AC, it will not affect the health of the people. That is how it has been. So we are standardizing it to 24 degrees. And otherwise, in summers, the temperature is set to about 21 degrees and in winters it is about 23 to 24 degrees. But this is as of now, but any other updates which I will be getting from my management, I will definitely share with you.
Thank you, because we need such inputs. Even as teachers, we need to discuss in the class in future. So such inputs are important. Do you think, like it is your personal opinion, because you have been an F&B person also, you are a rare HR manager who has had a hoteliering and teaching background. That's why I'm asking you. Do you think tabledot menus will come back greatly?
It will. we what we're going to offer is, you know, we'll have a la carte definitely, but set menus will definitely rule, because if there is no buffet, the people will definitely ask for something which is worthy a price. And they feel, you know, a starter, a main course, at least a three-course basic menu, a starter, a main course, and a dessert, and maybe a coffee could fit into a price. So it will definitely come.
We have another question from a student. His name is Samir.
Yes, please.
He wants to know that because of the present situation, the loss in business that the travel and hospitality tourism is facing, how as a human resource department are you dealing with their you know, queries or maybe their concern about job cuts or salaries? I'm sure there might have been some who might have got in touch with you asking about these. So are there situations like this, and how have you been handling them?
Yes, so thank you, Samir. You know, I think this is the most important question right now that we have.
I think you'll have to just keep your microphones on mute.
Priyanka, keep your microphone muted.
I think he can't even hear. He has left the place. Sukhbir, you can remove him.
Okay, I'll take this question. Thank you, Samir. No, this is a very pertinent question, and I'm sure, as you know, you must be thinking a lot how to face this industry. Now, see, the good thing about Tata and Taj is we think the manpower is our asset, right? Not any system, not any, you know, computers, not the chair that I'm sitting on. The asset is people, right? And we believe in building people, building career. Now, what has happened, see, over the years, so we have people in Taj who are working for 40 years. I'll just show you one thing. See, if you see this lapel badge, right? So this lapel badge signifies that I have completed more than 10 years. Currently, I'm actually, you know, in my 13th year with Taj. So every year, whenever you complete, you have been looked upon as a resource, as a more mature resource. And Taj and Tata, you know, has always first looked into people. If you recall the incident of 2008, where the Taj was attacked, I can tell you, you know, I had just joined Taj Hotels in 2008. And the best thing which I thought about is the hotel gets a salary to all the employees on the 30th of November. The salaries were there with all Taj Mahal employees. Right, Mr. Ratan Tata himself, he visited the people who were deceased, their family, and he assured them, and you know, he assured them that the salaries would come. If this resilience from the Taj employees had become a case study with the Harvard University, wherein the Taj associates had laid their life for the guests, it has become a case study. It is regarded, they are regarded as martyrs. We, every year on 26th November, we remember them. We really pray to God that we should have that strength and courage to come out of such situations. Now let's come to the present situation. Now the present situation, just give me a moment, please. Now the present situation is very challenging indeed, right? Now, as I told you, we have to work with half the strength. So we are identifying people who can be in the hotel, people who can be at their work home and can be working from home. Now, what is the need of the hour? The need of the hour is multitasking. power is multitasking, we cannot just say, because I'm an HR manager, I'm not going to leave my place.
I'm sorry to interrupt. Sandeepan sir, your microphone, you just have to mute your microphone. Thank you, sir. I'm sorry, sir, if you could please continue.
So, you know, multitasking, we have to forget what positions we are working, we have to forget our designations, and we have to reach out to people. My office, my HR office will be sanitized once in the day by the housekeeping person, right? The entire day I have to take care. If there is a requirement, I will go to the lobby to assist the front office. If there is a requirement, the front office associates will go to housekeeping in making rooms. So what we really need to do is actually pull in for each other, right? Now, as I told you, see, being Tata and Taj, see, we are absolutely in touch with all our associates. We are finding out whether they're currently, wherever they are okay. If they're in any requirement, if they need anything, we are trying to assist them with. So that is, has been the culture of, you know, Tata and Taj. And as I told you, today in this industry, multitasking is going to come in a big, big way. See, look at, see, all hotel management students, we all want to become a general manager. So what is a general manager? He is general for all trades. He cannot say, I'm general manager for front office, or I'm general manager for housekeeping. So every department reports to him. So the multitasking should come from the very beginning itself. See, when you go through a hotel management curriculum, it's an attitude building and a finishing school. You are taking through all the subjects, and you have to equally pass in all the subjects. You score good marks in all the subjects. So that is already built into the students of any hotel management schools, that you are actually a multitasker. Now, the industry always wanted, you know, you have to specialize in certain things. But then, now you have to change, and you have to help out each other. So if you are in front office, you have to be ready to help housekeeping and F&B service. See, food production is one area where actually, if you are not from that particular background, it is difficult. But for these departments, housekeeping, front office, F&B, you know, you have to multitask, and that is how you survive in this industry.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for answering that question. There's another thing that I wanted to ask was about the learning and the training in department of the hotel. So have you been designing any specific training programs for the staff with the COVID-19 so that they are well aware of all these processes that have to be done, the SOPs that are you now following that you've mentioned us for the departments of housekeeping and all the other departments. So are there any training programs also that you're running for your staff related to COVID-19 and the precautions?
Absolutely, absolutely. It's a very nice question, Mr. Bogal. So let me elaborate on this. See, training is everyday's part of life for us, right? But what happens when you are in operations, then you actually have to take out time for training. So we schedule sessions, but then we have to, you know, keep on calling people, please come over, right? Whatever said and done, if you ask me, I take care of the learning and development also as the HR manager. And I am particularly very happy. Now, people actually had the time to learn and be creative. In this entire lockdown, the positive thing is, we could actually share with them a lot of things. See, what we have done is, not only SOPs, we have very good back to basic modules. So if someone, for example, is in F&B, so we start with the basics of F&B, courseware menus, their examples, their cutlery setup, you know, then we go to wines. So we are tied up with certain wine companies, online courses also. So what we have done is our HODs and the shop floor managers, they had divided into teams. And they had been regularly conducting trainings on topics, and they were sending me the attendance and the course content on a regular basis for records. Similarly, from the corporate, what has been done is for all, starting from general managers, HODs, executives, managers, you know, they have designed certain courses which we had been undergoing in this period online. For example, they have designed a financial acumen and business acumen course, which it's a very lengthy course. It takes about 15 days at least. You know, you have to dedicatedly study for about 2 to 3 hours. So this has been enrolled to us. So you know, that has been done. Also, what we have done very recently is we have, the Taj has launched a learning platform on the app. They have launched a learning app which is shared with the associates, and the associates can now log in directly on the app and start learning. They do not have to only depend on a laptop or on a computer. So it is very pertinent. It is very important. As I told you also, the entire COVID safety related guidelines have been made into SOPs. Checklists have been made. They have been shared with the associates. We have taken examinations on those also, and the passing marks was 100%. So people have to reappear, those who couldn't score 100%, and we are ensuring everybody. See, we are expecting the lockdown to be over on 18th. So 18th, we are expecting our people to return. So when they return, the first thing that they should be doing is they should have passed this SOP test. So when they come in, after time office, they have to straight away come to the training session with us, where again we'll reinforce the requirement of safety, the requirement of PPEs, the guidelines that we have received before they're allowed to join their shift. Of course, along with this, we have to also get their health checkup done, their fitness done, so that they are ready to fit, not only for themselves, but for also for others.
Raja, I have a question.
Yes, sir.
That is, you see, it's like any hospitality curriculum would have one semester for industrial training. And it is also, I would say, it is not only that we keep on, blaming the hotels for getting cheaper manpower, etc. But it's a moral responsibility of the industry also to give an opportunity for the budding, to the budding hoteliers to get, their curriculum fulfilled, the needs of the curriculum. Now, you have to do so much with the existing employees. But at the same time, now these trainees who would come in, even, they would be looking up to the hotels that they would be going for their training. They will need to when the time comes. So have you given that a consideration?
Yes, sir. Of course, yes. And what we have done is, see, we had already selected a batch of trainees for our upcoming summer. Now, in this particular scenario, what we have told them is we will certainly honor whatever our commitment is, right? But only we can get back to them once the circumstances is absolutely normal. So what we have to do is we are also talking to our senior management in not calling every trainee all days of the week. So suppose I have taken 10 trainees for the summer batch. Now we can always call them staggered if required. Suppose in front office, my total manning would be for 10 in a day. And there are two people who are off. Now suppose in this scenario, what we can also do is we can put two trainees along with the 8 associates so that they learn also, and also it suffices the requirement in the department. So we do not want to expose everybody because we know there are health hazards and they have a long way to go. They have to follow all the norms. Every trainee that comes into Taj is taken through a very rigorous induction process in which all the brand standards, the safety standards, everything they are taken through. There is a test which is taken. They are inducted in the department once they qualify through all these tests. And of course, as I just mentioned, now we have to honor whatever we have committed. But maybe we have to little tweak here and there. Maybe it has to be a little staggered. Maybe we have to call two people in a day. And likewise, you have to give this opportunity. But definitely, we'll look into this opportunity.
Thank you, sir. I think the question that Anshuman sir asked would have been a question in the mind of almost the batch which is going out for the internship.
Absolutely.
So I think that well answers their queries as well. Anshuman sir, would you like to say something?
No, you said said on behalf of me, because I had asked the question on behalf of the students only.
Is there any other questions that we want? Because we are almost towards the end. It's almost 1:30. So maybe we can go around for a last question. If anybody has a question, can please let us know. Because this indeed has been a very good learning experience here talking to you, Mr. Raja Sadhukan, because this has been a challenge in everybody's brain, thinking about how things are going to be once the hotels open, right? So nobody better could have given us an example, the whole scenario than talking to you presently, since the hotel is operational, as you said. We have a question coming up. Okay, so we have a question from Rohan. He's more concerned about the effect on the newly graduated students. What will be the effect of these the pandemic on them? I believe that's in context to the jobs that they are looking forward for. Are there any plans or any strategies that you have, just like you had one for the industrial trainees?
See, we have already done our campuses and we have already selected our students. So the commitment remains, because if you have selected somebody, we need to place. The good thing with Taj in the last couple of years under the leadership of Mr. Puneet Chhatwal, our MD and CEO, is that he has been roping in a lot of hotels for Taj. So the Taj portfolio has been increasing, right? So there will be definitely, I'm sure, see, times like this will come and times like this will go, right? If we are too much fearful about what we are thinking now, it will stop our mental growth. We have to remain positive, right? Opportunities will definitely come. Hotel is something, especially in India, everybody, if you look to the TV channels, everybody is saying just one thing, that when it bounces back, actually, people are going to research and come back to the hotel industry and the hotel, and they're going to take the travel like it's the end of the days. Everybody's out of their home because people have been locked in the home for quite a long time. So if I may not be able to travel to US, but I will definitely travel to Darjeeling, or I'll travel to Chennai, wherever possible, I will definitely travel. And if the travel and trade industry, people will get their jobs, people will get their careers. The only thing that we need to keep in mind is that we have to not only keep ourselves safe at all times, we have to also think about others. If there is any lapse on my side, I can actually put others in trouble, right? The second thing that you need to always keep in mind now is you have to be multitasking. I cannot just say that I am only for front office, right? So definitely my interest lies in front office, but I have an attitude of helping other departments also. These two things would be the key of getting in a good position in hotels. And definitely hotels are going to surge, all the hotels are going to open, and we're going to see a boom in the industry, especially in India.
Thank you, sir. It is indeed being a very good experience talking to you here. I'm sure all these questions that the students had asked and the faculty here at IAS, almost every answer has been there through. So with high hopes and looking at all the positive aspects, right, it brings us more positivity to go ahead and fight this COVID and make place again in the world together. I thank you on behalf of the students and the faculty members here and the entire team at IAS School of Management, Siliguri. Thank you, sir, for being here and sparing your time with us and sharing all these insights of the present scenario, working conditions in the hotel during this pandemic. Anshuman, sir, would you like to say a few words before we say bye?
Yes, of course, Raja. Thank you very much. It's a personal thanks also from my side. I just needed to speak to you just for a moment, and immediately you said, yes, of course. So I'm proud to have you here with us. And even as a teacher, I feel so proud when you conduct such a session. Thank you so very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Mr. Bogal, Mr. Biswas, and the entire team of IAS and all the students. The only thing I would like to tell you that, you know, I always tell people to be very positive. So if just be positive, this time is interesting, but I know we are going to surely come out in flying colors.